Yellow Star can always show up as well. That Shen support, I think, is so good for these solo lane focused teams because he can still babysit Reckless up until there's a fight going on and be like, just kidding, I was there the whole time. And he has sort of the roam advantage over Albus, who has to actually pick and choose where he wants to be. Now we get to see whether that Kennen is going top lane against this Echo of Huni, or they are going to go for that dual lane down there. Nope, there's the Tahm Kench Jinx. There's almost the exact comp that AHQ ran to beat Fnatic the first time around, a really safe Jinx.
I actually like switching the Kennen to the top lane here and getting the Kench out because you have double assassination potential. You can obviously just take away your carry. Not only that, Kennen top lane has just so much peel. Just when people are rushing into the fight, if he gets behind though, if Zid falls behind, then HQ is again very physical damage focused, so that is one potential worry for them later in the game.
I don't think it's a big problem though. Jinx just does so much damage. If she has items on curve, she'll break through all the armor anyway. And the fact that this comp can work both ways. Kennen can peel, but also Tahm Kench can deliver Gragas or Kennen into the back line and be like, surprise, LeBlanc, you're in the middle of our team, and they can kill her off. So AHQ's 5v5, I think, is very strong.
Is it really a surprise though, the delay on that cast image? It's like, surprise!
Ku Tiger's demonstrated just how surprising that engage can be. I am going to keep my eyes on both Huni and Feathervent and their target selection in these team fights. Both of them are very heavy single target focus, but Tahm Kench can only swallow one of his teammates or one of the enemy attacking champions. So as long as Huni and Feathervent are on the same page in which different champions to attack, they can still have the potential to instigate what is a very squishy team as far as carries are concerned on the side of AHQ.
So if you think Fnatic can play that assassin style, get the lanes ahead, of course, that's a hashtag FNC win. But if that doesn't happen early into the game and AHQ get to the team fight phase, it looks favored for them. And if you think so as well, hashtag AHQ win. Let us know as we get ourselves into the game. It's the battle for first place. AHQ won the last one, but Fnatic can take it over with a win here. We're into the game.
They will be joining the first place seeds in London. And for Fnatic on the World Championship stage, we know they've been a team that has played around their top lane so heavily. Feathervent has shown a great proficiency in the mid lane to do what his team needs. This is old school Fnatic. Two assassins, two damage dealers, aggressive in your face draft. And now we need to see them execute it.
They do have a little bit less of a tank line though. Reckless, squishy, and easily reached. In Rainover, we've seen almost exclusively Runeglaive Elise here at the World Championship. So frontline tanks for a Jinx, there really aren't any. And On can easily break through this, will be almost impossible to kill. Albus even has exhaust to make sure one of the guys who gets back there can be stopped. Again, I think this has to be an early advantage for Fnatic if they want to win this game without some severe antics. And they go right away to look for the lane matchups with a couple of deep wards in the top jungle.
Yep, deep wards placed. HQ opts just do not mirror whatsoever. They already wasted two wards in the river, so preemptive warning. They expected people to fan out. Now one deep ward. And Fnatic pings out, so they know that that ward's there. They're guessing that the other wards are in those locations that they just pinged, so they're probably going to hover in the mid lane and wait until it's late enough for HQ to not be able to counterplay. Unlucky for them, there's no ward there.
Second time today, Fnatic have grouped themselves up once re-entering their own jungle, not running the risk of being caught out, not running the risk of giving up early first bloods, which we saw actually a number of times during week one.
This is playing into Fnatic's favor though. We have a hard leash for Huni and Rainover getting a soul camp. So Fnatic is propelling the top lane triangle forward at the cost of the bot lane. A bot lane that is just incredibly good at playing slightly from behind and going even. As in here we see Ziv going for a leash, double jungle. Just gonna check his XP here right here. What exactly happened there? Because I think bot lane took the Grom.
Yeah.
And Ziv bot put himself behind. Grom. So they're doing double camps here with Ziv tanking. So this could be very, very rough for Ziv in the top lane because Huni's already in the lane. Ziv is not even done yet, and he's behind in experience still.
You can see, yeah, Huni going to be well on his way to level 3. You can just see the recall starting now for Ziv.
What ended up happening here is AHQ thought this was a lane swap. They were playing under the information that this was a complete lane swap. Fnatic pathed around the ward that AHQ placed, and because AHQ lacked proper warding points, they're now significantly far behind in this early game.
Well, Huni's made himself up the top lane. He's going to jump in immediately. Timewind is putting some good damage down, and Huni, with an early advantage, he's got a number of pots, but so does Ziv, and the return exit damage evens out the trade.
It was Greedy from Huni. He thought he could get the second half of his Q to land on a Ziv. That wasn't the case, so Greeting for an extra auto attack and some extra Q damage. Took a bunch of damage back.
Feverbird in between turret shots. He doesn't even take a single turret shot to going in there, so very well timed there. Mastery of that LeBlanc.
Well, Ziv again getting jumped on by Huni, but again an equal enough trade. There's Marks of the Storm and last Shuriken. Just means Huni actually comes off worse for wear in that one.
Yeah, but Rainover's already inside Mountain's jungle. He will be spotted, but he took away the Raptors already, so he's just securing Huni's stay in that top lane.
Aggressive trading all across the map. Elvis throws out that Tongue Lash. Reckless will spell shield it. Rainover gonna get spotted by this ward, so Ziv will have the information to work. His Mountain is nearby. In case of
dangerous, a
dive, this is going to get risky. Frequent Rainover, he wants it. The cocoon hits.
They're going to land the flash cocoon. The chain stuns are there. There's not even a chance to get away. Rainover drops the Agrabah. Mountain's almost enraged, but his flash was down for a perfectly executed gank by Fnatic, even though Mountain was waiting.
That was so well executed by Fnatic, but you still have to put the blame here on Ziv. Reckless stays safe here in the bot lane. He's down 9 CS, but Ziv knew exactly what was coming. He knew who was coming, and he knew when they were coming, and he still died to that flash cocoon. That's a mistake you really can't afford to make.
And in every single game of groups here at Worlds, Fnatic has secured first blood. Every single match. And what a great advantage for Huni in that top lane. Experience, he's got two levels, a CS advantage.
The fact that Ziv TP'd to the lane because they played the lane swap game, because he did a jungle camp with Mountain and then showed up, he had to walk all the way up to the lane, missed a ton, and this is just like the last few Fnatic games. Huni is super far ahead and can break open the game.
I wonder if actually Fnatic communicated that ward in the brush, because Ziv came back really late to lane. Huni must have seen him put it. I think Rainover, if he knew that ward was there, would have actually not gone for the gank. So this is one of those weird cases where a mistake actually helps you later on, because that would happen in full vision. Usually that should backfire into a double kill.
And again, you can see Summoner teleport through Fog of War, and I feel like almost any good top laner should be looking for when that comes through and just simply time, hey, took more than 3 seconds to walk into the minion wave, something's up.
You don't even need to see the particle even. If you see him walk in with full resources and multiple potions at that point in the game.
But timing the jungle camp's hard versus actually the time between TP finishing and him actually showing in Fog.
That is true.
Either way, Fnatic are the ones that come away with the advantage. And we do see that Reckless is getting pushed a little bit, challenged. This lane matchup, as we mentioned in Picks and Bans, was going to be difficult for the Sivir Shen. Down 12 CS already, and the wave is pushing into Arn and Albus. They'll have the opportunity to play with some time on their side.
That is an acceptable opportunity cost of that benefit that Rainover and Huni got from that early jungle start, because they came to the lane the same time, but they were down half a level on each support versus support, AD carry versus AD carry, in a matchup that is already slightly tilted toward Jinx and Tahm Kench. So to go minus 10 CS is completely acceptable.
That might be acceptable, especially with the top lane winning Westor again on the bad side of a trade. That would have been a nice play there. I believe that was actually a... I forget what he mimicked. I think mimic R, but the chain still lands, gets some good damage. Reckless with a late spell shield this time, and because of the slows, takes a whole bunch more in the back.
Exceptional play in the mid lane, but Yellowstone Reckless are getting bullied. Albus has an acquired taste, but he won't be able to devour anybody and needs to back away.
You can see the mid lane still being pressured. I mean, Rainover, he got top ahead, so now he's just dedicating himself to the mid lane there. Westor having to drop CS into the turret.
Ooh, flash from Yellowstar.
He manages to get the taunt and is going to flash away, but now Reckless is exhausted. Two hits of Acquired Taste. Albus will devour him. Going to be able to regurgitate him backwards, and Acquired Taste will pop once more.
Beautiful.
And gets the rocket for the kill. Yellowstar's trying to run away. That gray health is so powerful. Both top laners have teleport and are level 6. They're teleporting in, but it's Rainover that's got the kill, and they want catfish for dinner.
And now Zave is forced to try to play cleanup, but he gets nothing done for it. A stun and also a lack of mana making it hard for Albus. This was looking pretty bad, but Fnatic show up first and they show up better.
Incredibly late teleports here from both these top laners while that fight was going on, and we could see what Fnatic was trying to do there. They wanted to hard push the wave and just force an aggressive trade so Ahn couldn't deny Reckless of any more farm. They thought Tahm Kench wasn't close enough, but he followed up with some really good stacks, and if Tahm Kench gets behind you, it is so incredibly hard to get away from him, because he will get that 3 stacks, devour you, spit you out, get another 3 stacks, stun you with Q, and then you just chain CC.
Febervent is really stamping authority on this lane. He didn't connect with the chains, but he did cast Ignite, so that's going to force Westor out of lane and away. Advantage mid and top for Fnatic. Quite a sizable disadvantage in the bottom. BF Sword for Arn's Jinx into the pickaxe of Reckless's Sivir. So that's going to hurt even further. And that's close, but no cigar just yet.
And Westor knew he was safe enough to be out that far without dying. He had triple longsword on his first back. Now he's back to base again to complete a couple of those pieces.
All right, watch this again. They think Tahm Kench is gone or far enough away to force a taunt flash, but Arn survives long enough to then peel. Traps could have used a lot, been used a lot better there. Double exhaust was still available, and Reckless gets regurgitated, but look at the pathing now from Rainover. Reckless drops. Yellowstar knows that he's going to win the fight because his junglers are close, and now both teams are yelling for TP. Quite funny that they actually come out instantaneously at the same time, be it very late.
Really fortunate by Rainover as well. Only takes one turret shot, and is just barely outside of range of it as well. There are no more turret shots that came through on that fight. It was actually quite close, but all said and done, a good battle for Fnatic, even though it's to the detriment of Reckless.
And this is the point where you really want to see those assassins spiral ahead and Reckless take another hit in the bot lane. You want to see Houdin go for 1v1s plus Shen ulti. You want to see Fevifen dive with the Shen ultimate, potentially assisted by Rainover, and take complete control of the top side of the map while you leave your utility AD carry to get 60, 70% of the farm, perhaps sacrifice a tower.
Reckless is doing a little better than that. Currently 7 down, and the wave seems to be pushing towards him. Boomerang will at least make that statement no longer true. But Arn is going to be trading. Rocket is up. Reckless slowed by that lash. And Arn has Super Mega Death Rocket, so got to be very careful for Reckless.
Yeah, take note of Yellowstar's positioning in front of Reckless. He just wants to deny any Tongue Lashes, doesn't want any stacks to be built on top of his AD carry. If needs be, he can taunt, but he really doesn't want to commit to a fight because that opens up Reckless for counter punishment from Albus. So he just hovers in front, takes as much damage as he can, and then taunts out.
This entire bot lane, though, for Fnatic is flashless. Albus is 6 as well, but Mountain has not yet made his way over to this lane, nor Westor for roam down to the bot side. We hit an exactly average performance for Westor right now, minus 17 CS at 10, his tournament average 18. So mid lane going just as expected for his opponents. Fevifen will see if he can use that later on.
Yeah, and Mountain's not had a great showing. He's been power farming for the last 10 minutes, has access to his ultimate, but look at the jungle of AHQ. There's a line of wards that Fnatic has been able to place thanks to Rainover's deep invades and pressure that he's applying. We'll touch on that in a second as now Yellowstar will see Mountain for the first time and he's able to dash over the wall.
They knew exactly where Mountain was. There's 4 deep wards in the jungle. He was power farming in full vision, then he paths over and he gets pinged out immediately. So Mountain can't even get a gank off just because Fnatic's vision control has been so immaculate.
Master prompts to Fnatic, then Rainover does have his rune glaive done. No sightstone for him just yet. It's been bot wards plus Yellowstar making that all happen. Mountain now being chased down the river, Scuttlecrab battle happening briefly. And despite this BF sword advantage, we're not seeing the CS lead grow at all for Arn.
It might be a little more difficult for Reckless now that his wave is pushing again back up. It stayed actually neutral for a lot longer than I felt. And every time we take a look, Arn and Albus are positioning forward to trade, and I think that could be why they're losing maybe some CS in the process.
It becomes a sustained war where you just want to keep trading out AD carry all attacks on each other until one side runs out of potions. Luckily, Reckless still has one potion available, and Yellowstar has Relic Shield to sustain up. Arn is taking for every all attack on the support, he will take minion damage. And Rainover is in the top side. Ziv is being zoned out, and he's building full MR.
Getting chunked out by Huni, and MR or not, the Elise is still coming through. Rainover knows he wasn't spotted. Great! Great flash there on Reflex. Gets away from the cocoon.
Huni committed his Chrono Break for that one as well. Trying to look for the phase dive empowered auto, not going to find it, but again, zoning Ziv away. That's 2 or 3 waves worth of minions, experience, and gold that Ziv cannot touch. Reckless, Stand United is going to get channeled. Summoner Heal used as well. Yellowstar's just been delivered for potentially another.
Gets a massive taunt though. Albus will take the last turret shot. That is a kill. Yellowstar is going to flash away from Body Slam. Mountain takes another turret shot.
Fevifen's coming in.
Fevifen's coming, but Westor's coming in from behind as well. Here comes the teleport in from Huni. If he can reach, no home guards, but the chain will land. Yellowstar stepping too far forward. Arn gets his 3rd kill of the game and a wasted roam from Fnatic.
Scary, scary situation for Fnatic when Jinx is 3-1. The tower dive will cost AHQ their top lane tower, but they are getting their primary carry fed. And that's going to be a difficult toss because as long as Arn is alive and kept alive by that Albus Tahm Kench, could be a worry for Fnatic.
And that just boils down to greed. When Rainover is making a play, while he passed through the entire top left quadrant of the map jungle-wise, he has to respect the fact that the enemy jungler will be in the bottom right side of the map, very likely speaking. Then the dive comes in. Reckless should just never be under this tower. Even with Shen Shield, there's just not enough if he doesn't have the flash to really get out of that initial CC, it's disrespect to go for that play. Even when Fabian rolls down, this is almost the best case scenario that you can hope for, where Albus drops to a good town. Then the mistake comes in right now, but you can argue what you want. The initial mistake definitely was staying under that tower and just relying on Chenulti to be enough to protect yourself from a dive.
And I want to highlight and really emphasize how much these three kills on Jinx mean for AHQ. When Fnatic lost AHQ in week one, they had a gold lead from minute two into the very last minute of the game and still lost because Jinx was carrying every fight and unkillable thanks to Tahm Kench. The exact same formula is happening right now. There are assassins, there is a gold lead for Fnatic, but Jinx will not be easily killed and she is ahead.
Especially with that Tahm Kench, another champion that was integral to that victory for AHQ, and part of the
exactly
reason
why she's not going to die.
Exactly part of why it's been banned out. Take a look at your itemization, because now that large CS lead has been built up by Ann, he's got the makings of that IH. Rod of Ages has been stacking for Huni since 10 minutes in game, so currently should have around 4 stacks. And Huni will give some backup to Vebavan to at least take down another tower. So gold advantage to Fnatic, but here comes the delivery. Albus will be bringing some support, and he eats the cocoon. Fnatic trying to get away.
Vebavan forced to run away. Pop the ulti. The W is not back up. Has to flash. There it is. Gets himself just away, but Westor is still on the hunt. Huni says, don't you freaking dare. But now getting jumped on. Thankfully dodges the rest of the skill shots. First death mark means nothing for Westor.
No, we did not actually see the Abyssal Voyage deliver, and that means he's now left alone in the bottom lane, and Reckless will be shoving that wave up to get some more damage down. So 2,500 gold, thanks to the towers being secured in favor of Fnatic.
Yeah, and this is exactly what Fnatic's plan was coming into the game. Minor flaws in execution with Reckless dying and on getting ahead, but they still have a 3,000 gold lead because the top side of the map is vastly in favor of Fnatic. Two towers down, complete vision control, the entirety of the game. Mountain has yet to really get any good unpredictable ganks up, but Huni is taking a fight here, though.
He will find Huni, delivered himself to the doorstep, tried to steal away the red buff, but spotted out by Ward's easy gank comes through.
And this is the third or the fourth time already in this World Championship where Huni's operating with more above average vision and still dying to skirmishes he just not should participate in at all.
Now, Reignover was in the bottom half of the map. Huni's death will at least result in a dragon for Fnatic, so it's not all bad. Solo lane still with heavy CS advantages.
I wonder, this is giving him too much credit, I'm sure, but I wonder how much this is intentional. Outside of dying, Huni's very good at pulling the enemy team to the top side of the map when Dragon is up. Deaths, you'd like to avoid those, of course, but at least there is always something traded when this happens, or almost always.
Yeah, Fnatic just plays with a very offensive mentality. They know if one part of the map fails, they can always cross map. Reckless, yeah. How long do you respect it? How
Reignover,
much do you respect the brush?
Reignover's in the jungle.
He's aware by how he's jumping, but not even needing the spell shield ulti to walk away. There's no chance to catch him. The question is, will anyone else show up? There's no one in range. Teleport's not going to get used. Nothing.
Not sure if that was really worth. We did see at least Reignover and Febavin in the right-hand quadrant of the jungle, but still a long time away. And we'll have to ask PTL Mycheck to have a listen for those dragon calls. Maybe it is premeditated from Fnatic.
But I mean, look at the deep wards from Fnatic. They don't even have a ward in their own jungle. They have 6 wards spread out in the enemy jungle. That's more wards than the average team has on the map right now, usually when they're at worlds. And they're all placed offensively. Mountain can't do anything in the dark in Fog of War unless he actually starts counter-drilling. But then Fnatic captures his respective threat. So just can't stress enough how good their vision control is this game. And that's why Fevin has been playing up so far.
And even though AHQ don't have quite the same vision control, at least it's on the right place on the map. Mountain is constantly down at this bottom lane, ensuring that On and Albus are safe. They finally get the first turret. It's through their one winning lane. And now a big gank. Reckless again, just
left to the wolves.
Sitting alone.
Sorry, left to the AHQs, not the Flash Wolves. Fevin, though, and Reignover will get some more damage on the mid inner turret. Huni was pushing up top, so yes, they're losing Reckless, but it is in favor of are they going to get this actual tower?
They're backdooring it, but the Elise Spiderlings are all dead now. They die in one shot apiece, and you only have 3 at this level. Easy pickup down to the bottom lane. Tier 2 goes down.
Fnatic, while they have all the information to work with, they're not playing the reverse bingo game right, because you really, if he's not in the top left, he's not in the top right, he has to be in the bottom right corner of the map, and you just have to yield. Give up the CS, and whether it's Reckless overextending, having a bad game read, or communication falling flat and just not having enough time to really check all those wards, something is going wrong here though for Fnatic, and it could mean that HQ is coming back into this game, because earlier, they were 3,000 gold behind. Right now, they've shorted up to 1,000 gold. into a very assassin-dependent composition, which falls flat later on in the game.
Luckily for Fnatic, that assassin composition does have some tools to at least deal with the threat of Westor. Chrono Break, Hourglass can somewhat help when you've got to deal with the Deathmark. Eventually, we expect Reckless to be working towards a QSS as well. The only question is, can they dance around the Deathmark and still kill Ahn at the same time? That's the only thing Fnatic have to do in order to win these fights.
That's the entire point, and that's why I questioned the Diana ban, because Jinx has been the reason AHQ is winning. Okay, yeah, Westor pulls some bans, but Westor still plays his bit part. He loses in lane. It doesn't matter, because Ahn is the guy you're supposed to watch for on this team. Everyone else does a great job. A 4-1 Jinx, who's now knocked down her second turret in about 40 seconds, actually her third turret in 40 seconds. It's hard to deal with.
And I would see one of the problems with the LeBlanc into Zed matchup. Yes, you're playing an assassin, but because you have to itemize some armor, which is most efficiently a Zonia's Hourglass, you lack the assassination potential on these other targets because you just don't build well damage.
Yeah.
He will survive long, but now your AD carry is behind and he's utility focused. Your mid laner is a hybrid assassin, so to say, he kind of plays long in his time. And your Echo is kind of slowing up or getting there slowly, so Fnatic, they're falling behind right now in tempo.
Well, they are. We did see the Abyssal Voyage now starting to be channeled. Elbis is going to try cut them off. Yellowstar's trying to pull some aggression as well, and AHQ have to decide where do they prioritize the fight. Teleport comes in for Huni and Yellowstar, and a quiet taste before he gets taken out. Huni phase dives over the wall, and Fnatic are stuck in the pit. Feathervent's got some AoE, and gets eaten by Tahm Kench, regurgitates over the wall, and Huni's still looking for it.
They got him!
They've got him shut down, but it may not be enough. Double kill as Huni picks that one up. Reckless will get shut down by Mountain, and Feathervin's in full retreat. Gets the Mimic, that's gonna eat a Deathmark, and Westor will get one and not get a second. Albus eats him 4-3 as everybody wants to die.
Extended 4-3, but that's the kind of fight that AHQ wants. Jump in, take the team fight, your AoE is better, your general team fight's better. Pretty good play by Albus. He ate on, but only after the Chrono Break bursted him out. So as long as Huni was able to stay around, and because he's ahead and has a Rod of Aegis, he was able to pick him up after the Devour was done. And that's the requirement of Fnatic, though. They have to survive long enough to kill someone after Devour.
Couple really nice plays in that fight. Hopefully we get to track it later on, but in addition to that, there were also misplays. So some really sick outplays happen here. But most important, the way this fight started here, they get zoned out here. Good engage by Mountain here, burns his spell shield. So Fnatic on the back foot, and that will cost Yellowstar his life. And that will become very important later on as he paps down to check out who Tahm Kench is bringing to the party, because he will lose Stand United in this fight. Second big mistake is Rainover right now. He's going to miss Cocoon on Ziv or on Mountain Rider and delay the fight. So he's not participating in. The outplay, however, is what Huni and Reckless are doing right now, as they get baited in. So there's really really subtle plays, but big damage. They get baited, but somehow Ziv doesn't really get any stuns connected because good sidestep from Reckless. Then he flashes in aggressively. Look at the Huni, goes back in, sweeps on the back with his Q coming back. So some really fantastic mechanical outplays, but from the get-go, Fnatic were behind in this fight. And then Feverhood kills his jungler. It's like special delivery.
He delivered Rainover. There was a bit of a miscommunication. He didn't tell him Cocoon is coming out. That burst could have come through sooner. And then also popping back the distortion after Deathmark, not before. Yeah. That would have been a slightly different fight. Of course, still the first 3-for-3 would have happened regardless. Small mistake there from Feathervin.
Special delivery is what Feathervin was yelling. Infinity Edge is in both AD carry's hands, but it's a static shift already completed for the 5-2-1 Jinx. Ahn is a terrifying threat, but he needs to be a bit more aware of that Ghost from Huni. Dragon number one will be picked up here by AHQ only the second of the game. But look at Yellowstar. He knows Dragon's going on. Invade gets more deep vision down. So the vision is still deep, it is still aggressive, and it is still forward-facing as far as Fnatic's concerned.
The problem is Mountain's been living in the bottom jungle long enough that they forget where he's gone, and you know, you saw players like Reckless wait around the dead turrets for too long and give up kills. So AHQ, if they can get some of this vision back and sneak people across the map, good things can happen. The ping's around Baron. Looks like Fnatic owns the vision of that right now, and AHQ has respect.
Interesting game when you consider all the advantages Fnatic have, the exact opposite advantages that AHQ has. And it really will come down to mechanical decision making in these team fights. Rainover does get caught up by the explosive cask there of Mountain, but nothing further comes from it. Fnatic, they still maintain a gold lead, but the game is still very swingy in either direction. Mm-hmm.
And if the next fight happens very soon, it'll be a more interesting one because everyone's save Mountain is flashless right now. So number of outplays much smaller. Mispositioning spells actually mean even more. Fnatic have to really, really be careful about this.
Fnatic have moved in a lot of safer positional map-wise. Putting Sivir in the mid lane, it's a lot harder for her to get caught. And you have your double mobile assassins on the sideline. That's the way this composition wants to approach the mid game. So it's a lot harder for HQ to make picks here unless Fnatic really opt in for that fight. Meanwhile, Kennen is still being pushed in by Fevvin in the bot lane, so eventually we need to see what HQ's answer will be.
And at the moment, Ziv has teleport advantage. Hunis is about 10% of the cooldown left before he'll be up and available. And definitely one of the cruxes of Fnatic's team composition when it comes to these team fights. Luckily, Rekkles has been able to finish his static shiv in the last few minutes, so in terms of the arm race, just a little bit of sustain behind his opposite number. All the while, Westor's gaining in strength. Pickaxe now to add to his Blade of the Ruined King. And the game is just somewhat slowed down. No dragon to fight over, no easy tower to fight over.
And the whole landing phase broke down. That was Fnatic's key, is they had a bunch of big early advantages. They had the early game queen in Reignover's Elise. And then that stopped happening. That situation went away. So AHQ, all they care about is playing around on. And, well, Jinx walks slowly without kills, so slow and steady wins the race.
And it really is winning. Winner of this game takes first seed.
Yep.
Takes preferential placement in the quarterfinal draw, which will happen after our tiebreaker, guys. Stick around on stream. It will happen live on stage. Determine who will be facing whom in London next weekend. Right now, AHQ putting up a very strong fight. Both of these teams looking to go 3-0.
And we're just waiting for somebody to go into the bot lane, pressure in Ziv to maybe draw somebody away, and then Fnatic can get a lot of better angles for that Baron bait. Ahn just has his eyes set on this mid lane tower, though. Only three rockets should be enough, and there's a minion wave to take that down. And he's still waiting on his 3-4 item spike, so he's comfortable waiting for some more time here.
There's no Westor right now. Fevvin around the wings. There's the flash taunt, but Albus is exhausted. He can't get far away. Throws out on, but is still going to be reachable. Explosive cast buys some time, but Reignover chasing, getting the kill. Albus goes down. The 2-0 as soon as they spotted Westor. Now Mountain running.
They've got one, they've got two, and they're looking for more. Huni wants to cut Mountain north. Mountain is trying to buy as much time as possible. He's flashed away, and Fnatic make a smart call, set their sights on the turrets.
They already had the minion. Thanks to Huni winning the matchup, that was the lane he was already pushing. It might have been for Baron, but in this case, it's for a tier 2 turret, and the respawns still aren't in. 10 seconds on the comeback, so Huni can set up for the next turret.
Well, a lot of damage going down. Cocoon does not find Ziv. 50% of the turret has been dropped. Mountain is starting to recall, and as the minion wave is getting diluted, Fnatic peel back. So a kill advantage and damage on the inhibitor turrets.
Yeah, and this is exactly the style Fnatic loves to play. Just wait until you get comfortable with the pace of the game being slow, and then suddenly they strike. And then they just find this opening beautifully. Albus right there, he says, I can't carry the game, Mr. Ahn, but I can carry you.
Unfortunately, but it wasn't exhausted enough. From doing it so yep. much.
It wasn't enough, and then he got gipped.
Oh. I did not think you two were going to be this bad.
I mean this good.
Yeah, touche. They're more subtle. More subtle than I thought. But Fevvin tried to put some poke into Albus. Backs away from that Mimic. And AHQ, thanks to Westor, they did get that last outer turret down in that middle lane. If you look at the bottom half of the map, though, AHQ have had a slightly awkward pink ward, which I think just killed or timed out because a new one has been placed. And AHQ are now setting up vision around the Baron pits.
That's a good thing for them right now because a 5-on-5 team fight is what they want. The last battle was a 4-on-3 or a 5-on-4 team fight. Fnatic are good at winning those. And in fact, they're really good at picking their fights because their assassins can get in so easily. But Yellowstar's flash is now down. It puts more on Rekkles to do that. And there are no movement boosts for HQ. In fact, there's not even, I guess there's Gragas ulti for the disengage, but that's kind of the only great tool for that in full stopping and engage. So Fnatic getting in on those odd numbers fights is something they are going to look for. Trying to sweep what control they can of the Baron area. Dragon's up in 25, both teams have one. So the next one is not exactly important.
Well, this game is already longer than Fnatic's average game times today, where they've really just rolled over both Cloud9 and IG. And HQ, despite being marginally behind in gold, their team fight strength cannot be understated. There's no margin for error
no.
for Fnatic. Because if Fnatic do overstep or do not successfully kill Ahn, the resets and getting excited will kill Fnatic. I mean, it is
of course
really quite that simple. Vivian's now being caught out. He's going to flash away, but he just gets bounced back by the barrel.
Jumps back up right now. He's going to have an Alvis coming around. So Shen ulti's in, and now Mountain is the guy targeted. But Zed's around. They're going to go for Ahn. There's the hard dive. Can he get the time catch? Yes! Alvis saves him for now, but he's going to get spitted out.
And Vivian
perfectly times the W. Zonya's pop. Westor running, but the cleanup crew is here. Ziv has already popped ult, but he can deal a bit more damage. However, he's corralled into the wall, and Fnatic say thank you very much and pick up three. Three kills to one.
When there is no margin for error, Fnatic turn around, a gank on Febbervin. He was outnumbered, but he pulled the support in, and Fnatic have a fantastic team fight.
I mean, that mimic distortion Febbervin pulled out at the exact frame where Ahn was spit out by his support, that was some quality League of Legends. Just watching that fight go down, Reckless completely untouched in the mid. Sivir late game in these team fights where everybody's bunched up. Yep. There's so much AoE damage, and there's no way for HQ to deny that. There's no prom, no really exhaust. There is that one, but it probably didn't go down on Reckless that fight. So incredibly hard for HQ to win this fight if these assassins keep being so nimble jumping back and forth.
Well, that's the thing. On with this Alvis Tahm Kench is slippery like butter, and there's no margarine for error, but it still works out for Febbervin & Co. So Flash's ulti is still down for 8 more seconds here. So all they can do is run and wait for the team. Shen ulti is huge, and AHQ immediately realizes we've got to wait for Ziv. But the problem is Alvis brings On to the wrong side of the fight. On doesn't get any damage out in this fight. He is all of
Watch
their gold.
Right there.
So Ziv's ult means nothing. The instant kill by Febbervin. And even though Febbervin dies, it doesn't matter because there is no threat left.
Just the way Febbervin played that fight, you know, distortion usage, flashing out, just buying some time, sidestepping, not going into the traps, and then a prediction on that devour part two where you get spit out. That was just fantastic play.
Oh, Huni forced to chrono break back. He's going to phase dive away from the body slam. Mountain throws down the explosive cast, and Reckless is on the hunt. Alvis is backing away, and Fnatic, they do manage to get away unscathed this time.
Fnatic is individually outplaying HQ right now. They're punishing the mistakes while not making too many themselves. Like, they're face checking into that brush, which is a mistake, but then Huni sidesteps out of it. So mechanical outplays, and that was what was lacking in the initial phase, week one from Fnatic.
Fnatic's crushing in minion farm right now. Their ability to control the map, get the deep wards down, not be afraid of Mountain while AHQ is afraid of Rainover. Look at the minion leads, 70 in the top lane, 50 in the mid lane, only minus 20 for a lane that Reckless got destroyed in. Fnatic are winning by a lot of gold just from the minion farm.
It is working out. It hasn't equated into more towers just yet, but they've already chunked down that inhibitor turret to below 50% thanks to a teamfight victory earlier in the game. And look at Fnatic, they're setting up and playing with Vision around Baron. With a team that is so well known for their intelligent Baron plays, the threat alone forces AHQ to continuously evaluate it.
The game
How much darkness do we have? When do we need to check?
The game is played on two lanes right now, though. The bottom lane is completely void of any interaction right there. Minion wave slowly pushing towards Fnatic, so it's going to be hard to secure Baron. It's incredibly easy to secure a fight, though, for that Baron, so that's maybe what Fnatic is looking for. Albus is still waiting for some gold to finish that Mikhail's. He really just wants to keep on alive, but need to have better positioning.
Chompers come around. Q gonna do a bit of damage towards the red buff, and I actually didn't see who that went to.
No, someone got it.
A player got
Reckless
the Reckless!
Did.
The
Ricochet,
thank you, something. Thank you, observers. Good guys, observers. But this little dance around the objective. Vision is somewhat in favor of Fnatic. They've got a pink ward in and around them. The body slam does not connect. Flash will be replied by Rainover.
Another kind of misplay by Mountain, though. He didn't land the body slam flash, so he didn't chain the CC. He didn't get the knockback he wanted to. Rainover flashed because of the explosive cast, to be fair, but...
Oh, this is a good bait, though. They have to face check. Scrying Orb is available, so we can see it used. There it is.
Hello, peekaboo.
And now it's gone, and
now
HQ can try again. He's going to set up for the stun. They look for Mountain. Thankfully, he's able to get away, but
Stay
now from Huni's on the wrong side.
Mistimes the parallel convergence. You really want to wait for Huni to go in once that comes down. So, but that is nitpicking.
If he lands the E and Mountain checks close enough, you still get the root.
It's also those little things that make the difference. Febbervin's not gone over the wall. Cocoon does not hit, and Febbervin holds on the trigger finger.
They can rotate mid right now. Mid is open for Ahn to rotate, but he has been afraid consistently of these engages coming from behind, so a little hesitation here. Reckless passes in, clears the way, so That bot lane, though, for Fnatic is being pushed in heavily. So massive wave stacking up for HQ in a minute or so, minute 30 seconds. That will be knocking on the bottom inhibitor.
Three items and a QSS for On. And now in the inventory, very, very big champion. On the hunt, pop to find nothing as the recalls already came through. Fnatic lose a minute and a half long cooldown just to get some ward control back. Rainover also unable to smite away.
They need that ward control because they're actually going to send somebody up very soon to clean that wave up, because otherwise they know they're not going to get this Baron. So at best, what you can do is perfect vision control where you send one of your teleporters, potentially your Shen if you're really desperate, not the bot lane to deal with that wave. And then you go for Baron bait part two. And this is what we see. Doing a Baron bait while you're playing the map on two lanes is incredibly hard. Getting a fight, by all means possible, but securing a Baron uncontested, not impossible.
Hourglass and QSS picked up for Rainover and Reckless in the last few minutes of play. QSS for Arn as well. Deathcap for Ziv. So this power creep continues to grow, continues to escalate. And despite Fnatic's strong gold lead, they are now the ones again trying to force this objective. With Baron, they could really break open this bet.
Yeah, HQ have the signature anti-Baron ward. They have one in the top left corner in that brush, and then they have one right side, eye side of the pit outside of conventional pink wards. People are placed, if you're blue side, it's best to place the pink ward in the pit, because people are continuously warding over. But then you don't have vision around the little edges right there at the Baron, and that's where HQ snuck in one ward, and that's enough to control this tempo. Rainover, though.
Oh, he's in so much trouble. That hourglass will get used. Yellow Star's gonna body block the Super Mega Death Rocket and forced to flash away. Rainover still stays alive, but Arn gets the first kill. He's gonna get excited and he's gonna look for more. Westor will find the Shadow Shurikens, and that's Fnatic losing two members. The rest of them trying to peel away. When AHQ beat Fnatic last time, it was off a fantastic team fight that cost AHQ little to nothing. Is this the same? Does history repeat itself in the 34th minute?
Seems very likely. On got so much damage flashing over the wall in rocket form, completely crushed it. Fnatic are lucky they only lost a 2-0. AHQ, though, playing the more risk-averse style. They're not going to go for the Baron risk. They're going to go ahead and take Dragon with no problem at all. But I'm actually a bit surprised they didn't go for that Baron.
Yeah, they were afraid of Huni, who was still on 60%. Could potentially cause some troubles right there. Fnatic actually looking towards the Baron. They spam pinged it, and they're actually aware that if HQ go for Dragon,
Zed's in base.
But again, that ward right there, that Huni's ghost just passed, that is exactly what punished them earlier, and they still haven't figured it out. Because they went aggressively for Vision, and they were waiting for them. Fnatic did start the Baron.
Fnatic are trying. Tahm Kench can't get in the fight just yet, which means On is a possible target. Febiven chunks mount
down. Oh, he did it again!
Oh, dear lord, the crit rocket. Febiven
Huni
again
used
his
E on the Baron, and then again, special delivery. This time, Death knocks at the door for Huni. That is big.
That is massive. Huni has so much of the gold and about half of the kills of Fnatic. Delivered another one to On.
He's currently 4,000 gold over his opposite number. The entirety of Fnatic's gold lead is in Huni's back pockets. And he's taken out by a special delivery crit rocket. All of a sudden, that pressure's gone. There's no teleport to speak of either. So AHQ, they are the ones that can start Baron. They're a little uncontested. 7 seconds before Huni's even up, and even longer before he gets into this fight. Baron's below 6,000. It looks like Fnatic are going to set up the challenge, but the cocoon does not connect.
He doesn't help on Baron. Westor's already low. Febiven! Holy crap! He stole it! But the fight continues. Ziv zones him out. Reckless running and running away. Keeps alive with QSS, but still more damage from Ziv and co. Yellowstar pops ulti to do basically nothing. Two members already dead on one side. It's going to be another. On is on a killing spree, and Huni and co. will kill off Ziv. Now, Mountain, did you overstep? On is still around. Choppers come in. There's the kill for Huni.
The chrono break is still available if Huni's feeling aggressive. Look for the phase dive jump. Three members of Fnatic died, and for three members of AHQ, and Febiven stole the Baron.
That was a beautiful double-pronged attack there. One side, the jungler goes in. Vaynor gets the attention from Mountain, gets disengaged, and Febiven dashes over the wall. Mimic distortion to pick up the Baron. That is clutch.
And also so important to note that both Huni and Yellowstar have the Baron. The two people who can split push at no cost to Fnatic, or less cost.
No cost to position.
There we go, to position.
Big wave in the bot lane. Looks like Febiven will go over this one. He'll pick it up for himself pretty safely. Void Staff now done. Looks like Deathcap, I would assume, will be next. You mentioned earlier that Zhonya's Hourglass pickup slowing down the damage, but here we can watch that steal come through.
Yeah, just look at how the Alvis is doing a great job peeling or keeping Rainover. He gets bounced out, and then 850 is the Mimic Distortion damage.
Early smite.
Mountain, very big mistake. I just checked the damage. Mountain Smite deals 850 true damage. Mimic Distortion deals the same amount of damage before resistances, so there was absolutely no reason whatsoever to smite before that hand landed.
And then just clean up from Fnatic, despite Reckless going down. Took so long for the Baron to get chunked. Huni arrives, and he helps pick up a couple extra kills thanks to a Yellowstar taunt as well. And now with Baron-empowered minions, Fnatic set up a siege. Remember, the bottom inhibitor turret has been chunked down. Ladies and gentlemen, there's your drop down. Quadruple mystery gifting thanks to two Baron steals in two consecutive games.
And the bottom turret has been slowly regening, but it's still at about three quarters here, so a bit of an easier time. Fnatic have that second dragon, so they also do bonus damage to turrets. That may help them in the future as well.
They also set up the split push in the bottom, so that's now pushing out, but that's going to take a while to arrive there in the bottom lane. So, while Fnatic did get the Baron and they have the Baron buff creeps, it's going to be hard to push into a Jinx if you're not split pushing, because the AoE crits do not get reduced at all by those Baron buff minions. They only care about magic damage. On is doing a wealth of AoE physical damage, and he has enough peel from his team to allow that to happen.
And again, we're just going to keep reiterating, if Fnatic pick one more bad team fight at this stage in the game, AHQ can just run all the way through Fnatic's place. Luckily, they have inner turrets left, and Rainover, he's going to cocoon on. Arn's going to get at least devoured, and the rest of Fnatic, they've jumped in for the engage.
Feverman wants the kill, but he's not going to get it. Arn gets the shutdown, and now Huni jumped on by Westor. He doesn't have Zonias. That's going to be the second kill. A big misstep for Fnatic. They lose three. And now map control goes to AHQ.
50-second death timers. The only, you know, positive for Fnatic is there's a couple extra turrets in front of their inhibitors, but there should be an inhibitor at least. There's Rainover and Reckless to try and defend, but it's going to be tough.
I really want to see what actually caused Fevervent to stay that long in the fight that he got instigate. Also, Huni, he was waiting for a good timing to use his ultimate, but I believe Ziv actually just CC'd him right in that moment, and he got one shot, so he didn't even get his ultimate off. So really solid player, HQ knocking on the inhibitor door.
15 seconds, how much can they gain? Bottom inhibitor, turret is open, but they don't overstay their welcome. AHQ gonna dip back, maybe get a couple of wards down and set up for this dragon spawning in a minute. It's the only objective easily contested left on the map. There's no chance of getting caught on the recalls, as Fnatic are still dead for some of this.
Now, luckily for Fnatic, they only lose like the least worst out of all outcomes, which is the middle inhib, especially if you're playing, again, AoE wave clear. Carry like Sivir can easily push up that way, so they can still control the map, but more importantly, they just lost another window where they could have gotten ahead further. They could solve this problem in terms of push, but right here we see Rainover Path. Look at Alan, he switches immediately to Reckless too. Even when he's cocooned, he knows Albus can save him, and now Feverman wants to go in. Does he get body slammed? Yes, he does get body slammed, knocked up, and immediately blown up here by Arn. Exhaust came out too, and that's enough to win that fight. Now we're going to look at Ziv and what the interaction is with Huni. Yep. AoE stunner and gets blown up immediately, and at this point, there is no way for Fnatic to win the fight.
And that's not the first time that Fnatic have been a tad over-aggressive. Yes, you need to make plays with your double assassin comp to get those kills, but want to be the right ones. You need to have a little bit more support. 1v4 is so, so risky. A couple of members of HQ dancing around this dragon, but it looks like Fnatic have the support.
No!
It's smited. Mountain takes it.
Early smite for Rainover. Tried to time it with his Q, but hit smite about an eighth of a second too early. Mountain times it perfectly, assuming an early smite. Gets that one correct. And that's actually three dragons now in AHQ's favor. They are winning the dragon game.
Yeah, and this movement speed bonus, denying it from your opponents and getting it yourself could be looked as like a 12% swing in movement speed, because they don't get it, we get it. So that's actually very big in the way these fights play out, especially if you're playing assassin-heavy compositions.
Fnatic, it felt like all they needed to do was split push, because if they can get away from Ahn, those team fights aren't going to be won anymore. Ziv, though, with the death cap now starting to really power up in terms of his damage. Ruin King, Last Whisper, and Yomu's for Westor. There are some other threats.
Well, the room has gone silent here in Paris as AHQ have super minions in the middle lane, sieging the top lane. Reckless has been left to wave clear duty, but look at Mountain. He's waiting in the wings to deliver a barrel to try catch Huni out. Huni's been just burst down and chunked down. Arn's gonna get excited thanks to the tower, and look at those crits. They get Death Rocket held onto for now, but another tower falls.
And this is where not having an inhibitor becomes very, very hard for Fnatic to deal with, because Westor is just guiding those minions into the base, and he will start soon threatening the Nexus towers. Then Fnatic has to peel one guy backwards, and suddenly they have to defend that top lane inhibitor tower somewhat 5v4 with one guy clearing the minions at the Nexus, so very rough to deal with that.
Luckily for Fnatic, AHQ didn't have a minion line up top to really work with. Cocoon hits on Ahn, but there's no support. Albus is going to get devoured.
That never gets old, though.
TP coming in, though. They want this fight on. Off in the wings, and Hooney wants in. Here comes Shen as well. One more eat, but how far back can he get? Mountain buys time. The taunt lands on QSS as he's exhausted and trying to run. Hooney, can he get the damage? Oh, he can't. Ahn gets another kill. Almost will get chunked back. Here comes Westor. Reckless QSS gets the kill back. Three kills for Fnatic. Now Yellowstar hit up by Ziv. The taunt comes through. Reckless still alive. It's only Ahn who's up.
Kill everybody but the guy you want to kill. Screw it, Fnatic say. That's what they'll do.
This
a 4-for-1 trade. Ahn's trying to recall. Look at the minions in the bottom lane. Reckless wants to meet them on the inhibitor turret. And Feathervin and Rainover, they just want to delay Ahn. It misses. Ahn's going to be able to get
side.
Home. And they will be able to get the tower. Ahn should get in place to defend the inhib.
If he had stopped the recall, that could have been game over. Instead, it took two shots to get the crit and get the kill.
This Jinx had an answer for everything thrown at him. Suddenly the remaining parts of their lineup from HQ did not. They all fell, but Ahn playing fantastically well here overall. Really good sidestepping kiting. I don't think he could have played it any better whatsoever. The problem was, instead of trying to win the fight in the remaining, everybody was watching Ahn, including the remaining HQ members, and they just simply got picked off one by one in the wake of that chase.
There's no teleport coming in from Ziv either. He has to TP to the mid lane because there are no wards down. The overchase, a great flash by Ahn. But then, yeah, everyone's just piling in. Reckless is not a good target for Westor. He has a QSS. He did two fights ago as well. Ziv just doesn't have quite enough damage. And this is gold at work, because all four of these guys would have died if Ziv weren't so far behind.
What a game. The Cocoon also preventing so much of that damage from Rainover. When he connected onto Westor, Baron has respawned. Inhibitor exposed in the bottom lane. Hooney's down! Westor found him! 1v1, and now Fnatic need to try pull off magic. There's no teleport available either. And Baron, surely this is going to AHQ uncontested.
You can't stop this one. Minute Hip respawns, but who even cares? A big power play available now for AHQ. They've got 50 seconds with no enemy top laner.
5-item Echo, but not a single Zhonyas in there. When you're playing a champion that can go back to your ultimate into a Zed and a cannon, I think this is just a very large itemization mistake from Hooney. There's no excuse not to have a Zhonyas in that build against this lineup.
Well, 30 seconds left before Hooney's alive. Over 2.5 minutes before the teleport's available. And Febivin, that was cheeky, trying to pull attention. Reckless gets 50% of his HP lost from a single rocket. Tower drops. Inhib will fall, and most likely the middle one as well.
It's at least two inhibs for sure. You can't defend this one, and there's still 15 seconds to choose what they want to do. No dragon up just yet. They don't want to overstay their welcome in the mid lane. Oh no, maybe they do. They're going back for the top side.
The winner takes first seed and goes to London. The loser has to play Cloud9 for a shot on. He's going to get devoured by Albus, and AHQ will be happy with their inhibitors, and they will back away.
But now all of the cards are in AHQ's hands right now. Pocket Ace is coming into the final push right here. And you know, they've even got the King of the River with the lineup, so it shouldn't be hard at all.
Yeah, AHQ playing with the rockets right there. Ready to go in. They're in such a good commanding position over here. Westor going in on Hooney. Hooney wants to hold his ulti, but yeah, he should press ulti here.
Oh, he did it late.
Wow.
Simply outplayed. You need a Zhonyas, but you need a Zhonyas against the Zed. It's just a hard counter item.
Straight miscalculated that damage.
I mean, even Westor has 183 magic resist. He's got a Guardian Angel, Mercury Treads, and this Maul of Malmortia. So even though he is building offensively, as again, you're mentioning, Hooney needs a Zhonyas, he still managed to keep himself to the point where he's not going to get one shot at either Hooney or Febivin.
Gold is still in touching distance, gents. 3,000. We're getting to 50 minutes on the game clock. And with Baron empowered minions and what's that, three cannons? AHQ are looking to take another inhibitor.
1 minute left on Baron, dragon up in 3 seconds. Chunking Albus means nothing here. And Ahn is safe. Pretty good wave clear though. You can see what kind of damage
exceptional wave
Echo could do. But Jinx can do even more. Cocoon means nothing.
Albus saves the cooldowns.
Hooney's being chunked out though on the back, and those rockets are just melting the tower. Albus will get onto safety once again as that last cannon minion stands. Supers just getting to the mark of the inhibitor. Evervent looking for more poke.
But just like how confident Ahn is in his support, every time he just walks up, he knows he'll get crowd control to engage on. It just requires Albus to peel him. So Tom
Big
Kench, this game
side.
Is the biggest proponent to this Jinx getting fed.
There is a teleport available for Hooney and a couple of wards in the jungle, but Fnatic on the verge of losing their third inhibitor. Yellow Star should go down to this death mark. The face of the mountain will not save him. Ziv's looking for a stun, and he's found Rainover. We do see Ziv getting down. He's dunked by Reckless. This could be the final fight.
Feather
and Reckless alive! They killed him! Double kill for
Feather! Oh, no!
And Hooney gets more!
They can push for the base right now. They can knock down Westor. Now's the time to go. You've got more than a minute. Can these guys push enough? But keep in mind, three inhibs are dead. The base would die without intervention.
The crowd is on their feet, and Fnatic find the AoE damage to kill AHQ. The timers are ticking. 50 seconds and counting for Fnatic to finish the game.
And they're going to use Hooney as the guy to defend. Again, triple inhibitor death means more minions than the base can handle. Fnatic walk forward. If they can knock down the mid turret, they can get at least two inhibs. But I don't know if they can get the Nexus yet.
They have Spiderlings available, so they're trying to reset tower aggro on the Spiderlings. They have one lone minion that comes in. Remember, Hooney has teleport available. He
saved one. That's
saved
huge.
One minion, so they can reduce the tower aggro if they can double tank these towers. But they do so much damage. Look for Spiderlings to tank.
20 seconds till the respawns come in. Hooney sets up the shield. They have the cast minion. It goes down, but the other turret is available. It is backdoor buff, but